Good evening, everybody. Tonight is just a video on what is the quickest way to set up PMR, GMRS or FRS channels or MURS on your radio. Bearing in mind, the user is responsible for checking whether or not the device is compatible with those and meets the type specifications and what the restrictions are or licensing requirements are in your country. So, this is for any radio that is compatible with CHIRP. For tonight, I'm going to be using my UV5RH. The reason I'm using my UV5RH is because I have gone and left my TID radio H3 in the car and its battery's dead. So it's been getting a lot of use. So I'm using the UV5RH, which I haven't used for a few days now. Anyway, straight into it. Got my UV5RH. Here it is. Turn it on. It's currently in a blank state. I'll show you what I mean by that in a minute. I'm getting my CH340 plugged in. Remember, you've got to push it in firmly because sometimes the bottom one doesn't go all the way in as it should do. Right, and we fire up CHIRP. Now, the version of CHIRP I'm using today is CHIRP's version as of the 29th of February 2024. Where is it? About. There it is. Oh, sorry, the 22nd of February 2024. Today's date is the 29th of February. Okay, so if I go to radio, remember, you always download from the radio first. Download from the radio. I've got COM3, which is my CH340, it's a Baofeng. Now, for some reason I had it in my head, you could see the UV5RH in CHIRP, but I had a look back at my old videos and no you don't. You use the UV17 Pro or you can use the UV5RM. Where is it? You can use that one as well, that works. Anyway, so you use UV17 Pro, not that one. Not the Pro GPS, this one. And we say yes. And we tell them what to read. And there we go. I can see the radio is being read. And we get here, and as you can see, I have a blank. Nothing in this radio at all, nothing pre-configured. So the quickest way is to do this. Go to File. Go to Stock Config. Right, let's just do PMR first. So let's go to European LPD, which is low power device, I believe, and PMR. And you just click on that, and it brings in another sort of like Excel sort of spreadsheet here with the different channels for PMR and the LDP, the low power ones. Next thing to do is to go back to File again, open Stock Config, and look for FRS and GMRS. Here they are. And it will open yet another one, and as you can see them down here, there's a GMRS and FRS. Then you go to File again, Stock Config, and let's just throw the MERS in as well. And it brings up another one. And there's the multi-use radio system, I think it's called, in the US. Anyway, and you've got them. Now then, what you do now is you just copy these across. So let's do the FRS and GMRS first. So let's click on that one and the last one. Hold down the shift key and click there. Right click and copy. Go to the Baofeng. Click on here and then Control and V. As you can see, those have come into here. So let's go and grab the PMRs. Remember, though, having PMR and GMRS FRS on the same radio is pretty pointless because I don't think they use the PMRs over here. They might use a radio. They might use the frequencies for something else. Again, it's up to the radio user to work out if he's allowed to transmit or whether or not the device he's using to transmit is type accepted and what his license is. Anyway, GMRS, I think you just need to pay for a license, but you know what, guys, I'm getting at. Anyway, back into here again, so the PMRs, so I selected them all again, and I right click and I copy. Got a Baofeng again, let's throw them down here, let's say, I don't know, let's start them at 100 and paste those in. Oh, yep. And then last one, we go to the MURS channels, click on there, copy that, and scroll down here, and let's throw these in at 200. So, let's have a look at the radio. So you have, I don't know why I left that one blank, I'll just leave it like that. You got your FRSs, GMRS, although GMRS and FRS do pretty much use the same channels, they're just different, powers and different modes, like the narrow FM or just standard FM. Anyway, and here's the GMRS repeaters, which, as I say, I don't really go into, but anyway, I've been asked this question. We scroll down to 100, then there's your low power device, LPDs, and your PMRs, and then further down at 200 you've got your MURS. So we've got these into this. So what we do now is we go to radio, upload to radio. So we've got the Baofeng, yep, 17 Pro, and click OK and go. As you can see, it is now writing that to the radio, and the radio is now going to reboot. Right, so let's put this radio into, there it is, so we're in FRS, so you can see the FRS, let's go down to, let's unplug this, let's go down to, see, there we go, if you look on this side here, 200, so let's go down, so it's green dot, blue dot, MERS 1, so then we jump down again, there's the PMRs. So see, it's automatically jumping because the other channels don't have anything in there. So you got the PMRs in here. That's going to be a bit of a step, so let's just go to 050. And there's the GMRSs. And then it goes into the PMRs. But anyway, that's how you do it. It's very, very simple. Now, I've already backed up this radio with the channels I like. I don't use these ones, but as I say, somebody asked me and thought I'd do a little video on it. Now remember, all you can do now is you can use this to program any radio that is compatible with CHIRP. So I could throw my TID Radio H3 in here and do the same thing. My Baofeng 17L, my 25, the even my UV5R, although I'm not too sure there's enough channels for that, but the UV5R will do it. Even my old UV82, which I still haven't done a video on it. And I've had that one for almost as long as I've had my 5R. But that's how you do it. It's pretty simple. It's all there, all in CHIRP. It's just copy and paste. Have a good night, guys. 7-3s.